Moldovan border.
Just the border? What kind of fucking border is this?
Welcome to Moldova. No one wants to go to Moldova.
Yeah, it's the least visited country, one of the least visited countries in the world.
Moldova. Yeah. Also, a really interesting fact I saw on TV once. Moldova had 30% of its national income stolen. Like 30% of the government's money was stolen by mobsters and gangsters and corrupt politicians and wired all over the world, billions of dollars.
He's done.
Tristan is me.
I'm Andrew.
Emery is him. Dave is him. Coverage, Tristan? Sure.
Maybe we're just finally getting stopped for that speeding.
Yep.
Got us.
The original? There is no, I don't have the original, I only have these documents.
This is what they give us.
You need to have the original document.
We can't, there's no like way we can, is there a fine or we pay a fine or a penalty? Anything we can do?
It's not about penalty or, it's about the car that cannot leave the country.
So we need to think of advanced maneuvers.
Such as? Pay a fucking taxi man from this crappy town to drive us the whole way, is what I'm thinking.
That's one advanced maneuver. Advanced maneuver two is to find a train station and see if we can get to Chisinau at least by train and get an overnight train to Kiev. Or we can find a taxi man and say, look, take us to Kiev. Here's a fortune of £100, life-changing sum. If you could fucking take us to the magical world of Eurovision. We've been there before, so let's at least find out how far Yash is. We can get to Yash and then we can fucking do our usual wave around loads of money to try and attract someone who's happy to do as we say.
Yeah, I like this plan.
There's lots of travel blogs, and I guarantee none of those travel blogs will ever take you to the places we know in this series. We go to the most fucked up, weird places where there's like a genuine threat of getting shot in the head for your 18 euros. We fearlessly adventure for you fans at home because we're kind, considerate individuals. We put our lives on the line.
It's supposed to be short
24
term.
24 hours times 7 days times 1.5 lei, which means if we park here for an entire week in the expensive parking, it's going to cost us £49.
Done. All week.
Said there's no trains to Chisinau until tomorrow. So we said Kiev, which is further, and then they point us to another stall, so who knows? Should've brought the fucking Lambo. Got there in no time. Gee.
From Bucharest to Kiev there's a train. But not from Yash, no? No? Okay, no problem.
Wait, ask about Chisinau.
What about Chisinau, Moldova? In the morning. Okay.
Done?
It's all fucked. Right, now we gotta start bargaining with people who don't speak English taking to another country. It's gonna be great.
No.
So where are we gonna try and get to? Kiev?
No, Chisinau. There's 0% chance they'll take us to Kiev.
Okay, Chisinau train station, and from there, hopefully, that's the like capital city.
We're one step closer. The head nodding of nose. And I am what I am. Am what I am. My favorite episode of the series so far.
Take one. There's a few more.
Chisinau, Moldova. Chisinau, Moldova.
Again, Moldova.
Moldova, capital.
My man's like, what? Do you want to go where? Like jumping in a taxi in London saying, Paris, please. But much worse, because the car can't make it probably in one piece. You can do this?
Drive, yes, now. Akum.
Baggage?
Baggage, yes. It's small. Meek.
How much?
130.
Sorry, again.
130
euro.
Euro.
Euro. 130 euro. Okay, my baggage is here.
Bought some dude a house. You know, he just bought him like a second condo in a holiday house.
You know, he's thinking, why do these three big guys who have an X6 need my taxi to get to Moldova? Now we're cruising, Dave. Finally. Hoping to see our friend again.
Yeah, Mr. fucking dickhead.
The head of Moldova Tourism Board.
Do you know what I mean? Moldova's bankrupt.
I'm personally a big fan of this taxi. Playing some absolute, get us in the mood for Eurovision, isn't it?
He sends 0%. Why did I agree to this? It's become so long. We had to go all the way back, park the car, leave it on the street. It's definitely going to get broken into or robbed. 100%. There was no trains.
I'll give you a discount on the grand, but call it 900.
There's a 0% chance of us finishing in the top 5, Dave. 0% chance.
There he is.
Mr. Badass. Mr. Chocolate Pudding.
Could jog across the border at a low pace.
A brisk walk would put us outside of his capabilities.
Yeah,
I don't think we should wave him. He looks really annoyed.
Yeah, he looks super angry. Let's not get rejected
for being too friendly on the way into the least visited country in the world.
Nobody
no one goes here.
No cars, no smiles.
No cars, no smiles. No fun.
What did you say, Andrew? I'm going to go to the nearest town, walk around with loads of money, and scream Chisano.
I said I'll throw money at the problem. That's what I said.
Yeah. This is what that looks like.
We found a way.
We found a way.
Yeah, we think so. In the boot, make sure we haven't got any fucking slim fast.
So you have more than 10,000 euro cash, narcotics, something like weapon?
I have loads more than 10 grand. My dick is a drug, and these are weapons.
You made it.
You done it?
Yeah. Through. You know, I think that if I was a minimum wage border guard, I'd take joy in refusing people access. Sorry, these are the rules. Goodbye. Sorry, I'd really enjoy that if that were me. So like when I worked at Luton Airport and people's flights were delayed and they'd be screaming at me and I was just the sandwich maker, I'd be like, well, I don't know what I can do to help you. I enjoyed that. So this man here, I think, had pleasure in turning us away. Oh, those three guys in the BMW offered me a bribe. No, I'm a man of principle. Well, guess what? Now I'm in a cab sailing through the border and there's nothing you can do to stop me. You can search my case for drugs. I don't have any drugs.
Took your month's wages and blew it. Bam! Blasted it into fucking solutions, you bitch.
Dr. Bluetooths were so far from Beats by Dre, but those are super far from Dr. Bluetooths. Those are like Nurse Red Tooths.
How would you describe this place?
White Africa.
This is a sight I was not expecting to see.
Got Andrew investigating how we can get to Kiev. I feel like we're making progress. Right, when's the next bus?
Bus is don't go to Kiev.
I said, why? War?
She says, no Kiev, we never go to Kiev.
Okay, who goes to Kiev? Us.
Eurovision.
No taxi.
We're in like the least visited city ever.
There's not a single taxi here.
When I said to my boys in Bucharest, I'm coming here, they said, you're going to have problems there. I said, why? He goes, there's very little money, and the money that is held by anyone is mafia, all. I haven't even seen any money. Like, at least in Bucharest, you see Ferrari, Bentley, Gucci, Prada here. This is where in the capital. I can't even fucking find it. Can't even find a cash point, mate.
It's concerning. What's the plan of action?
The plan of action is to make a phone call to the Romanian girls who translate for me and try and get us first class to Kiev. Ah, one sec, I may not need you, I'll call you back. Okay, we need to get to Kiev as soon as possible. As soon as possible.
For today?
For today.
At 9:42.
Okay, and I arrive when?
Tomorrow at 3 o'clock p.m.
P.m., perfect. How much, do you have a first class?
No, only second.
Only second, first class is full?
No.
Doesn't exist.
We don't have.
Nice, old school tickets as well, aren't they?
Listen to the communist music. Stalin. I've worked out on my world travels that basically, if your cash card never runs out of money, there aren't many problems you can't fix. Oh, Lambo's blown up. I knew it. Oh, I can't take our car. Get a taxi to another country. Oh, there's no bus. Get a train. Give us a little cabin. There's nothing I can't fix. Because I make unlimited money through the magical sky.
No, you're in a shitty situation, literally. I'm doing a pan.
Yeah, like, this is the grand central station of the capital of the country. The card machines don't work, they don't take card, and the toilets don't flush. Welcome to Moldova. I mean, people say Romania's poor. Romania's rich. Romania's got everything England's got. Have you ever felt poor in Romania?
We need to get out of this thing so bad.
It does.